endangered for a variety of reasons, most of which are the direct result of human activities.
Over 2,000 whales are killed every year. This number is rapidly growing.
Many of the large whale species have come close to extinction over the past century.
Top three most endangered whales in the world are the northern right whale, the southern right whale, and the bowhead whale. Need some distraction.
Oh, beautiful release. Of the 13 great whale species, 7 of them are currently classified as endangered or vulnerable.
Why should you care? Without whales, there will be damage to the ecosystem. Whales are at the top of the food chain. Eliminating whales would lead to overpopulation of other aquatic animals.
Environmental changes such as increasing CO2 levels, global warming, and changing in feeding habits will also result from the extinction of whales.
Whale watching, which is a popular tourist attraction, has generated an estimated $1 billion to wealthy and developing countries worldwide. This makes a huge impact on a country's economy.
Overfishing, pollution, climate change, dam and bridge construction, private and commercial boating, and commercial whaling have caused whale populations to dramatically decrease. Historically, whale's oil, blubber, and other parts are used to make various products and goods such as lamp oil, soap, perfume, candles, and cosmetics. Today, whale oil is rarely used anymore.
Small-scale whale killings are primarily done as a way to obtain the whale's meat and sell it as food in countries that either loosely monitor commercial whaling practices or by those that use legal loopholes to continue whaling. Whale meat is considered a delicacy and may be sold at a premium price.
Whaling in Japan, Norway, and Iceland has become a major contributor to the endangerment of whales.
The International Whaling Commission banned commercial whaling in 1982, but it wasn't until 1986 that the ban went into effect.
Japan's history of whaling can be traced back to hundreds of years ago to whales being driven into nets, harpooned, and then dispatched with a longsword or wooden plug to the blowhole.
20th century brought about Japanese coastal whaling with steamships and grenade-tipped harpoon guns. In 1934, Japan began to expand whaling to Antarctica.
During and after World War II, whaling helped feed citizens, and by 1947, whale meat made up the majority of animal protein consumed. Whale meat currently makes up 1/4 of the Japanese diet.
Whaling has been a part of Japan's cultural history for decades.
Attempts to end whaling are perceived as a threat to Japanese culture.
Eating whale meat is considered an old and impenetrable Japanese tradition. A sense of pride fuels Japan's commitment to continue whaling.
Japan, Norway, and the USSR immediately lodged a legal objection to exempt them from the ban's effect. Japan was eventually persuaded by political pressure and is now bound by the ban but has found ways to get around it to continue whaling.
The banning of commercial whaling has had a largely positive effect on improving the current condition of whales in Japan.
Unfortunately, Japan's whalers have recently been able to exploit a loophole in the founding treaty of the International Whaling Commission, which allows whaling for scientific research.
Japan claims its need to kill whales is to obtain basic biological information about the animals, such as pregnancy rates and age at first reproduction.
Japan lacks scientific results from their studies, leading the UN to conclude that they have gone against obligations under the International Convention for the Regulation of Whaling.
Australia sued Japan in 2010 after accusing the country of taking advantage and violating loopholes and obligations.
Japan practices two types of whaling. Deep-sea whaling over the course of several months with a fleet of ships, and day-trip whaling, which takes place around the local coast.
Pollution has had a major impact on whale populations in Japan.
Chemical pollution, oil spills, and garbage are contaminating the water that whales live in. Similar reasons are harming dolphins who live in the same area.
In addition to physical pollution, noise pollution from man-made equipment such as loud jet engines, sonar, underwater explosives, and other equipment interfere with echolocation and can cause damage to whales' hearing.
Construction of bridges, dams, and waterways affect traveling whale pods by separating groups of whales and preventing them from being able to meet up with family and friends.
Overfishing has caused a dramatic decrease in sufficient food supply, causing them to leave to find food or to starve to death.
Although it is by accident, whales are occasionally struck by private or commercial boats, severely injuring or killing them.
So, what can we do to solve this problem?
To decrease overfishing, we propose enforcement of stricter bycatch laws and closely monitoring catches.
This will ultimately limit the amount of unintentional catches and leave more fish for whales to consume.
Attention should be focused on keeping harsh materials out of the ocean.
Costly fines for littering on beaches, increasing community involvement to help keep oceans clean, and protective measures should be taken to prevent spills and other types of pollution.
Climate change is unfortunately inevitable. We can reduce the rapidness of climate change by reducing CO2 emissions. Calculating your carbon footprint is an excellent way to cut out emissions from your daily life.
The construction of dams and bridges in the ocean should be heavily evaluated before going into effect.
Although aquatic construction may be beneficial to humans, there's a great chance it's harmful to the life of the ocean mammals.
Aquatic construction leaves whales lost from their families and friends, as well as making the search for food difficult.
Heavily enforced tracking of whales and boating routes will help to prevent the accidental striking of
whales. Decrease the endangerment of whales. One of the biggest solutions is the abolishment of whaling, primarily in Japan, in order to prevent whaling from escalating any more than it has already.
Countries, specifically Japan, should be banned from using whales for scientific research.
They must follow the guidelines of JARPA, and if they fail to do so, serious measures should be taken.
It is up to us, as humans, to preserve and save these innocent creatures.
For just $5 a month, or 16 cents a day, you can adopt a whale in need.